We got Burton Gilliam from Blazing Saddles. What was it like? I mean, take me through it. How much fun did you have? It seems like you guys had a blast. Not to mention the fart scene, but I mean, you guys had a blast with that movie.
Well, I am the first person in motion picture history to fart. Mel says, I'm going to make you famous today. And he told me I knew what we were doing. I didn't know it had never been done. He said, you're the first.
Wow.
So I don't know if I'm in the Guinness Book of Records yet, but I should be. but it was, you know, for me, I was brand new. I didn't know what acting was anything about, much less all about.
Right.
So every day was different for me. And if Mel was sitting here right now, he would say, you know, Warner Brothers gave me $3 million and told me to go have fun, and that's what we did. We had no idea that it was going to be what it has become.
Oh, yeah. It may be the funniest movie of all time.
It is, and that's what Mel
said. I think it is. Yeah. I think it is the funniest movie of all time.
We won't argue with him on that. I'm so glad that I did that picture. I was a fireman in Dallas, Texas, and he called and begged me to. And
really?
That's his words, not mine. He begged me to be in Blazing Saddles.
now, nobody had any idea, you know, what it was going to be when it came out, right? This is all new terrain for you guys.
And nobody had any idea. But after the first 3 days, it was like, oh my gosh, we've got to go see this. And that's back in a time when they didn't do four-walling in Los Angeles.
Right.
They, it showed at one theater, the Avco Embassy,
right.
For 9 straight months. But I think everybody in Los Angeles saw it right there at that time.
All right, now Burton Gilliam, Blazing Saddles. You who's
Honeymoon
left?
In Vegas too. He was Elvis personator in Honeymoon in Vegas.
Right,
I had Elvis Utah chapter.
now I got to ask you this though. I mean, now take me through the fart scene. I mean, first of all, it's never been done before. And how do you guys keep a straight face as you're doing this?
Well, here's when we did it. You know, we do it had to be funny. Stupid.
Right.
But, you know, the first couple of times that we did that scene probably 35 times, at least 35 different directions. I probably did it 100 times.
How much beans did you eat?
The first couple of times we did it, naturally, we were doing our very, very best. But after a couple of times, I mean, unless you're really really something superhuman, you have to just say, well, I give up. Bring in the extras or
bring in the extras.
let them do some scenes from off camera or something.
Burton, do you talk to Mel? Have you seen him at all? I mean, contact?
I talked to him about 3 weeks ago.
How's he doing?
I haven't seen him now. About 18 years since I've seen him. I live in Dallas, Texas.
Mm-hmm.
And I do get to Los Angeles every now and then, but we just haven't crossed paths, haven't had lunch, and we should because there's 3 of us. We ought to get together sometime. We just haven't done it.
I got to ask, I mean, is he like this? When you see Mel being interviewed, when you see Mel perform, and he's so funny and he's got such a great personality, is that what it's like working with him when he's your director, or is he more the taskmaster, like, do this, do that?
I'm glad you asked that because on the set, when we're not working, when we're in between setups and stuff, he's Mel Brooks to the core. But boy, when that assistant director says, roll 'em, action. I mean, when they say action, he's got a one-track mind. He's just into what he's doing, and he will almost run over people, directly. He's another person when he's actually working. But boy, the rest of the time, he's Mel Brooks all the way. He can, because of that, he's that way, At the end of the day, he will have probably stepped on a few toes, you know, but he will.
But it's worth it. It's worth it for the product.
And he'll make sure that, hey, I didn't mean to jump on you. And it's not the actors. It's the cameraman, the sound man, or the grips, whatever, you know. But he will always say, hey, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to. I'm just thinking, I had it all in my mind. I wanted to go this direction.
Oh, Burton, thank you so much for
coming. Patrick Lavery. If you're interested in what you've just seen, be sure to click the New Jersey 101.5 logo to subscribe, comment to join the conversation, and share with your friends.